Good evening, everyone. This is Andy Boxall at the National Weather Service office in Sullivan. It's a little bit before 8 o'clock on Sunday evening, and I wanted to kind of give an update on the snow potential for tomorrow. Of course, we've been talking about this now for a couple of days, and unfortunately, still a lot of uncertainty as to how things are going to play out. Starting about this time tomorrow evening into tomorrow night and through a good chunk of the day on Tuesday, in fact. Still really watching the potential for a couple different scenarios to play out, especially with the northern edge of the snowfall. Really two potential ways that this could play out. The first being a little bit more of a northerly track, which would bring heavier snow into southern Wisconsin, especially that tier of counties closest to the Illinois state line. On the other hand, if the storm system stays a little bit further south, if that sharp edge of the sharp northern edge of the snow that remains a little bit further to the south, and then in that case, much of the heavier snow is going to likely remain across northern Illinois. And the far southeastern corner of the state, just seeing some light to moderate snowfall amounts. And unfortunately, still not a lot of clarity at this point as to how things are going to play out. Kind of want to illustrate this scenario with what we call a plume display. This is for Burlington down in southeastern Wisconsin. And you read this as time increases from left to right. Those lines increase with increasing amounts of snowfall. Each line actually depicts a slightly different version of a weather model. It's what we call an ensemble modeling system. And you can see I've circled here in red and in black the higher solutions and then those lower solutions. Some of those lower solutions are on the order of almost nothing to just maybe a couple of inches, whereas further up there toward this upper part of the screen, you know, those could be amounts in excess of 6 inches in some cases. And you can see a little bit of clustering with each one of those potential scenarios, indicating that those two potential solutions of the more northerly or more southerly track. One of the other things that's really in play here is the effect the dry air is going to have on this system. The high pressure is currently located over northern Minnesota. That's going to slide to the southeast tonight and into tomorrow. And winds will increase from the northeast across the area tomorrow ahead of the system. And that much drier air mass really has the potential to eat away at that northern edge of the snow. And that's why we think there's probably going to be a very sharp northern cutoff to the snowfall. You know, we're talking perhaps 0 to several inches of snow over just a couple mile period, wherever that line sets up. So this always introduces a lot of uncertainty into the forecast, just what impact that dry air is going to have, because it's not only just the dry air at the surface, but also further up in the atmosphere that we have to keep a close eye on. So hopefully as the weather models continue to get more observations, both the surface observations and the weather balloon upper air observations, we can start to get a little bit of a better handle on what effect that is going to have on the snow. Overall, main thing that we want folks to keep in mind, still, as I mentioned, a lot of uncertainty. We do think that where snow begins, it's going to, where snow falls, it is going to begin tomorrow, probably about this time, early to mid-evening. The peak snowfall will likely occur tomorrow night and into the first part of the morning on Tuesday. And then during the day Tuesday, and even maybe into the first part of the evening on Tuesday, we are going to need to watch closely the far southeastern corner of the state. So Milwaukee down to Racine, Kenosha, over to, say, Burlington, maybe down to Lake Geneva for some lake effect or lake enhanced snow with those northeast winds coming off of Lake Michigan. We may see some slightly higher snowfall amounts across that area, but also potentially see those amounts stick around, that snow stick around a little bit later into the day or even the first part of the evening on Tuesday. So certainly would encourage folks to keep up with the forecast. We'll be going through things again tonight, looking at the latest data, and again tomorrow as we fine-tune those details. Weather.gov/MKX is the best place to get those updates. As always, stay safe, and we'll see you soon. Take care.